Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the United States, and I'm making this video that the Lord led me to make called The Lord's Message to the Philippines. And brothers and sisters, every country God deals with in a different way, because the Bible says to whom much is given, much is required. So the United States comes from a historical born-again Christian background, and so the Lord holds us to a certain standard. And the Philippines is supposed to be the only Christian nation in Asia, but actually it's a Catholic nation. It's still about 89 or 90% Catholic today, even though, you know, and it was 98% Catholic before the United States came there at the Spanish-American War. Brothers and sisters, the Lord has a message for the Philippines. And what can we see? I want to tell you, brothers and sisters, that in the Philippines, those of you who are watching, I've been a missionary in the Philippines for over 7 years, and I'm in the States now, but I'm still a missionary in the Philippines. I'm going to go back there by the grace of God. But anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm going to put a link to an article below this video and show you that when the Pope is getting ready to visit there in Manila, they took all the street kids and locked them up, chained them to poles and all this other stuff. These are the kind of things that we typically see not in a Christian nation, and any nation with any kind of humanity. And humanity comes to us from the Judeo-Christian background, brothers and sisters. Go look at the, you know, these other countries in the world that are Muslim and all these other things. We see the, you know, the lack of holding life precious. When, you know, when a culture believes that becoming a jihadist and a suicide bomber and all this is not holding life precious. Whereas with God, all life is precious. So we see godless people by the fruit they bear. Like in America, people getting abortions and all this. We have over 1 million abortions every year in the United States. This is godless, demonic behavior. So when we see a society that would have thousands of street children, like in Manila, there's thousands of street children, always, and they're doing drugs. A lot of them, they sniff this glue. It's called rugby. That's what they call it. They sniff this glue and all these other things, and all these people just abandon their children all over the country, you know. And it's so in America, they have abortions, and in there, they let them be born, and they say, oh, we don't believe in abortion. We don't believe in divorce. The Philippines, with their Catholic facade of Christianity, they say, oh, we don't allow divorce. But what people do is they just get separated. And then they go live and shack up with somebody else. And then they both shack up with somebody else. And then millions of Filipinos, because in the Philippines also, they make all this long process and expenses to go through to get married. You have to go to seminars. You have to do all this stuff, spend all this money. So what people do, they just don't even get married. They just shack up. Say, oh, we're a moral country. We don't have divorce. Well, nobody gets married, and then those who get married, if they don't like it, they just split up and then just live with whoever they want to, and that's it. So it's only a facade. So when the Pope is coming, the Philippines is putting on this religious facade that, oh, we don't have street children. Oh, we're, you know, we don't have poverty. We don't have all these social ills and problems of all these children doing drugs and all that. We don't have people abandoning their children. We don't have abortion. Yeah, you let them be born, and then you just abort them out of your house and abandon them in the street. It's a religious facade. And brothers and sisters, that's the whole message that the Lord has for the Philippines. When you look at the Catholic cathedrals, like the Vatican and all that, what you know, in your human eye, in the natural eye, you're saying, ooh, it's so beautiful. Ooh, it looks like heaven. Wow, it's so nice, so grandiose. Ooh, this must be from God. No, you're looking at the outward appearance, brothers and sisters. You're looking with the eyes of the flesh. As I said in a video the other day, Jesus was born in a manger. He was not born in a fancy castle, in a palace. He was born in a manger. Don't look for God in people-pleasing palaces, but look for God among the peasants, among the people who are poor. You will find our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, not exalting this facade. So when you see the Pope wearing that grandiose, outrageously expensive, and he, you know, he has tailors who sit there. You know, there's people who are assigned to make his clothes, sew them by hand. All this, like the royal kings of Europe, especially in the old days. You know, in the Egyptian pharaohs and the Babylonian kings, all of this grandiose clothing and stuff that is the opposite, or the antithesis, or the anti thing that Christ would do. When Christ came to earth, he came born in a manger, and the son of, it was supposed, the son of a carpenter. I'm sure he did an internship as a child. He was a carpenter until he started his ministry, as the Bible says, at about 30 years old. He didn't live in the king's palace, but lived as a carpenter, and lived in the house of a carpenter, brothers and sisters. And then, the reason why the Lord led me to make this video is because The problem in the Philippines, brothers and sisters, is God says in Amos, among other places in the Old Testament, he said, because you worship idols that cannot see and cannot speak and cannot hear, I will make you like those idols where you cannot hear, you cannot speak, and you cannot see. And that's what the Lord has done, brothers and sisters. People are deaf and dumb and blind spiritually. It's a darkness of spirituality, not being able to hear, see, or speak the things of God. Brothers and sisters, the Lord allowed the strongest typhoon in the history of the world to hit Tacloban in Leyte in the Philippines. Same place where MacArthur landed. Same place where MacArthur landed, symbolizing at that time especially, you know, the Christianity, the freedom, you know, the liberty that we have, our constitution. We gave the Philippines a constitution. Their Independence Day used to be the same as ours, July 4th. They copied our constitution. Then they changed it to June the 12th. They moved away from that. You know, that idea that the freedom came from the Judeo-Christian background. They want to go back to the Middle Ages. They want to go back to their captivity and as a colony to the Spanish, you know, the Holy Roman Empire, the Spanish Inquisition and all that coming from Roman Catholicism, to that bondage that appears to be freedom and liberty and democracy, but in reality is a facade where we lock our children away and throw our children away, then lock them away so we can have this mighty outward presentation like that, like the Vatican or like the dress of the Pope and all this pomp and circumstance. Definition of religion: man-made ways to God. Man-made ways to God instead of coming to God as he truly is, as Jesus told us in John chapter 4. God is a spirit, and those that worship him would worship him not in Jerusalem, not in the Vatican, not in any building, but would worship him anywhere they are in spirit and in truth, is what the Lord told us, John chapter 4, when he talked to the woman at the well in Samaria. Anyway, the sign unto you, O Philippines, when the Pope went to Tacloban today, I mean, I already knew it was going to happen for several days, there's another low pressure area, another tropical storm hitting there that the Pope had to cut his trip short to Tacloban. Now he's going to go to Manila where they've got all the children locked up, and guess what? The storm's going to come up there and hit tomorrow, where he's going to be up there. Brothers and sisters, this is a sign unto you. God allowed this destruction to come that he might bring the Philippines to break off the facade, to break off the grandiose outward appearance, and stop worrying and hiding all the internal corruption and morality problems and all this in the Philippines. Bring it all to the light. And this is really the message to the Lord to every Catholic, former Portuguese and Spanish colony in the world, from Mexico to Brazil to the Philippines, anywhere. Take off your religious outward facade. Stop reporting false numbers to the UN. And even stop worrying about what the UN thinks. In the Philippines, when the UN rates the Philippines as the most corrupt nation in the world, they go off the deep end. They don't say, let's stop corruption. They're like, get mad at the UN for putting us on the bottom of the list. What can we do? Who can we bribe? Who can we kill to get our names off the bottom of this list so that we appear to the world, to Babylon and Babylon's religion, Roman Catholicism, that we are a Christian nation, that we are a good nation, that we are somebody. Take off that facade. Take off that religious spirit and be set free by the blood of Jesus. Now, all the Filipinos I know who I've prayed with, they want to be close to Jesus. They want to be saved. But you know what they tell me? I've had hundreds or thousands of Filipinos in the Philippines tell me, I want to be a Christian. I know what you're saying is right, but my family will disown me. The religious police, those old women, there's always the old women in the family who are the enforcers, who are about to die, and they want to make sure that nobody enters the kingdom of heaven but through them and their traditions. And they hold their children and grandchildren in bondage to their demonic false religion. May the Lord set those people free today by the blood of the Lamb. May you have an ear to hear, Philippines, what the Spirit says to the church.